Hello, my dear children and parents. Welcome to Indus Valley Public School RAT e-learning classes, where we will be doing a poem from your English book, that is First Flight. Name of the poem is Dust of Snow. This poem is composed by Robert Frost. Robert Frost, a well-known American poet and a nature lover poet. So children, in this poem, he used some of the items from nature in order to describe his mood. It is highly a symbolic poem. This poem represents a moment that seems simple but has a larger significance in life. So here he used crow. Crow, that's is a symbol of death and fear. Here, crow represent depressive and sorrow mood of the poet. Then he used hemlock tree that is covered with snow. Okay, small particles of snow. It represent, or you can say, hemlock tree is associated with poison and toxicity. Whereas, hemlock tree is covered with snow. So snow is associated with purity and the transformation of the mood of the poet. Okay. So in this poem, poet tries to convey a message that it is we can have a positive change in our attitude even through negative things also, as crow and hemlock tree both represent negativity. Even the little things can bring a big change in life. Simple act of kindness done can inspire others with enthusiasm and may bring huge change. Okay, so now moving towards the explanation of the poem. Let's have a look. Dust of snow, the way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree, has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. So now, in this poem, first we will see the rhyme scheme. The first four lines, we have AB AB, crow and snow have same sound, so AA, me tree, same sound. So here we will see the rhyme scheme is AB AB. Then we have enjambment throughout the poem, because no punctuation, only at the last we will see a full stop is there. So, enjambment throughout the poem. Okay, children. Now, I'll let you know rest, figure of speech or poetic device later on. So, now we will see in the first stanza, the way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree. So, in the first stanza, poet describe a simple natural happening. The snow is falling heavily. The snowy flakes have covered the top of the tree. The poet is standing under a hemlock tree because he was going somewhere and he took some rest under the tree. Then suddenly a crow came from there, came from somewhere, and he landed on the tree. Okay, so as he landed on the tree, so whatever the snow was there, it falls on the poet. Okay, so this poet, the poet was standing under the tree and the crow came, so snowfall came on the poet. That the crow, a symbol of ill omen, and the hemlock tree associated with a person, okay, is not auspicious thing. We know whenever crow comes or hit your head or something like that, as the color of the crow is black, and black is associated with darkness. So here you can say that poet is saying that ki crow, symbol of ill omen, a darkness, and hemlock tree, poisonous tree, all these two things, okay, these two things together makes a situation where poet is very unhappy. Okay, this resemble that poet is very unhappy. Fine, let's see what happened in the second stanza. Has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. So now in the second stanza, the falling of snowflakes and the scene, okay, and that scene leaves a tremendous effect on the mental state or you can say mental mood of the poet. Means as soon as the flakes of snowfall comes over the poet, immediately his mood changed. Previously his mood was off, he was upset, he was depressed, but as soon as the flakes of snow, that flake means dust of snow, okay, halka sa jo uska dust hota snow ka, that came on the poet, so immediately the mental status that was depressed changed into some other mood. Okay, so that was a small thing, no, particles of snow had changed the mind of poet. So far the day had been quite gloomy and wasted for him. Matlab, before the snow dust came over him, his day was waste because he was in depression. But as soon as the snow fall him, his mind changed, and what happened? So this ordinary natural happening suddenly brings the desired change in his mood. It gladdens his heart. Somehow it gladdens. He realizes that the falling of snowflakes on him has saved the day. He has no regret as the whole day has not gone waste. The moment of the snowfall and their effect have saved the day. They had brought a change in his mood and gladdened the upliftment. Uplifted his spirit. Okay, so now again I will explain you once more. So the way a crow, that means a crow somehow come from somewhere, and commonly a symbol for death and fear. So now shoot down on me the snow, dust of snow, that means as he landed on the tree, so that tree leaves got shaken and had fall, and there was a fall of snow on the poet. Okay, so now and then what happened? Has given my heart a change of mood. Matlab ki a good act means falling off, you can say snow, this was the good act, lift the poet's spirit. Okay, it lifted the poet's spirit and it enlightened its time, enlightened its thought. Okay, so now here rude, according to you can say its meaning, means to feel regret or to have remorse or sorrow. So now here he is saying that ki his whatever the time is wasted before the snowfall on him, now after the snowfall he has totally changed, and he thought ki jo hua so hua, now I will be doing good towards my rest part of the day. Matlab jo bhi kuch ho chuka hai, let's leave and then move to the other good side of the day. Okay, so now we can see that a poisonous hemlock tree covered with pure white snow, and poet who is depressed. Okay, at the moment the black crow, that is a symbol of death, shake the pure good snow onto the poet, that all goodness help him to change his mind of depression. So now he is able to heal himself. He is able to convert his thought. Hope you have understood the poem. Okay, so now coming towards the poetic devices. So I have already told you two poetic devices. One is rhyme scheme. Then I have told you about enjambment. Now you will see assonance. Children, assonance means wherever you have vowel sound coming together, like in line number 2, stanza number 1, shook down on me. So their O sound is coming continuously, like shook down on. So O ka sound is continuously coming. So whenever you find such kind of sound, no, that is assonance. Fine. So in the stanza number 1, line number 2, we have this thing, assonance. And then we have alliteration. If you see that in second stanza, first line, has given my heart. So HH ka repetition, has in heart. And saved some part, third line, second stanza, SS. Again a repetition of S. So it is alliteration. So how many rhymes, this thing, poetic device or literary devices we have? We have rhyme scheme AB, then we have enjambment throughout the poem, then we have assonance in line number 2, first paragraph, shook down on me, because O vowel sound is coming. Then in stanza number 2, in the first line we have alliteration, has heart. Then line number 3, saved some, we have alliteration. Hope you have understood the literary devices also. So in the next stanza, I've already given, go through the literary devices. So rhyme scheme AB, CD, or you can say AB, whole throughout the poem. Next, alliteration, the occurrence of the same letter or sound at the beginning or adjacent or closely connected words, like has given my heart, HH, and saved some part, SS. Then we have assonance. The prominence of a vowel sound throughout a line is called assonance. So in first stanza, line number 2, shook down on me, O sound is prominent. Next, enjambment. So when the same sentence continues to the next line without the use of any punctuation mark, it is called enjambment. So it has been used throughout the poem. Okay children, hope you have understood the poem. Any doubt, please do call me up. Thank you. Before that, one conclusion is that the poem teaches us a lesson that very small act in life can illuminate our soul and motivate us to do better things. Okay, this is what the learning we have from the poem. So my dear children, thank you so much for watching the video. Any doubt, do call me up. Thank you.